हेलो फ्रेंड्स, लेट अस नाउ लर्न सम इम्पोर्टेंट टाइप्स ऑफ हर्निया। सो इन द टाइप्स ऑफ हर्निया फर्स्ट वी विल सी सम इम्पोर्टेंट पॉइंट्स अबाउट डायरेक्ट इंग्वाइनल हर्निया। सो इफ यू सी डायरेक्ट इंग्वाइनल हर्निया, हियर द सैक विल एंटर Via the deep ring. If the sac enters via the deep ring, we call it as indirect inguinal hernia. And then it goes through the inguinal canal and it will come out of the superficial ring. It will go out of superficial ring. So here this indirect inguinal hernia will actually start from the deep ring, go through the inguinal canal, and then it will come out of superficial ring. So if you see, this will be something, it will come like this, it will come like this, and then you will see the herniated sac here, foveal here. Okay, this is indirect inguinal hernia. Next, if you see direct inguinal hernia, in the direct inguinal hernia, in direct inguinal hernia you will see that the sac is protruding directly from the posterior abdominal wall. It won't go into the superficial ring and then the deep ring and then superficial ring, all that won't be there. It will directly be protruding from the posterior abdominal wall via the triangle of Hesselberg, and then it will enter the inguinal canal. So now let us learn the boundaries of this triangle of Hesselberg. Triangle of Hesselberg, laterally you will see inferior epigastric artery. So you will see, this is the lateral, you will see inferior epigastric artery. This is the umbilicus. Laterally, you will see inferior epigastric artery. This is inferior epigastric artery. Then you will see medially, you will see lateral. This is the umbilicus. Umbilicus will be somewhere here. Okay. Medially, you will see lateral border of rectus abdominis. So this is the rectus abdominis which you see. And if you see the floor inferiorly, it is made up of inguinal ligament. If there is a sac which is coming out from here, this is called as direct inguinal hernia. Now this is done. Now what about the, if you were asked what is the relationship of sac with spermatic cord? So if the sac is posterior to spermatic cord, if the sac is posterior to spermatic cord in direct inguinal hernia, in direct inguinal hernia, the sac is posterior to spermatic cord. The sac is anterolateral to spermatic cord in indirect inguinal hernia. It is anterolateral to spermatic cord in indirect inguinal hernia. Then, if you were asked what about the relation of neck of, if you see, if this is the pubic tubercle, here you will see pubic tubercle. If the sac is present here or here, see, if the sac is present, if the sac is above which is above, and even medial. Not even here. This is the pubic tubercle is here. So here, if the sac is above and medial to pubic tubercle, then we call this sac as inguinal hernia. Okay, if the sac is below and lateral to pubic tubercle, then we call it as femoral hernia. Okay, so this is about the relations. Now we have learned about direct hernia and indirect hernia. Now let us learn the types of inguinal hernia, types of indirect inguinal hernia. Types of indirect inguinal hernia. So what does this indirect inguinal hernia, what are the types? Indirect inguinal hernia are divided into three types. One, we have bubernosal, then we have funicular. One, bubernosal, then we have funicular, then we have complete or scrotal. Okay, in bubernosal you will see that the sac is in inguinal canal. This is the scrotum with the testis. Okay, the sac is present here itself. So here this is the sac is in inguinal canal itself, then we call it as bubernosal. Then in funicular, the sac has been come down up to the scrotum, but it does not go into the scrotum, it is separate from the testis. So here if you see, the sac this is actually processus vaginalis, right? So this processus vaginalis or the sac is closed above the epididymis. It is closed above the epididymis. Through this processus vaginalis, the bowel loops will come here. Okay, so this is processus vaginalis. This is closed just above the epididymis. So through this, you will see the all the bowel loops coming into the scrotum, but you can feel them separate. The content of the hernia is separate from testis. Hernia is separate from testis. Then we call it as funicular. Okay, then we have the complete scrotal. In complete or scrotal, in this, the if this is the sac, so it is continuous, complete. So this, you cannot feel it separate. So the testis appears to lie in the lower part of hernia. You cannot separate the testis and the hernia in the complete or scrotal type. Or the herniated part is present in the scrotum. So these are the types of indirect inguinal hernia. Now, let us learn about the some definitions. Okay, some definitions or some subtypes, or you can say it, or named hernias, or you can tell it has named hernias. So what are the different names of hernias? So we have something called as irreducible hernia. In irreducible hernia, in this the contents of the sac cannot be reduced back. Why the contents of the sac cannot be reduced back? This is due to the formation of adhesions are formed between the sac and the content. Because of the adhesions which are formed between the sac and the content, so if this is the sac and if you think this is the bowel loop, okay, which is present in the sac, now here there will be formation of adhesions between the sac contents and the sac. So as a result, they cannot pass down. That is irreducible hernia. Irreducible hernia. Then we have next type, which is incarcerated hernia. Okay, what do you see in this incarcerated hernia? In incarcerated hernia, here the contents cannot be reduced. Even here the contents cannot be reduced, but here it is due to the presence of fecal matter. Because of the presence of fecal matter, the fecal matter in the bowel, so the bowel cannot be reduced. Okay, then we have obstructed hernia. What do you see in obstructed hernia? In obstructed hernia, the intestinal obstruction, there is an intestinal obstruction is present, but blood supply is preserved. Intestinal obstruction with preserved blood supply is seen. That is obstructed hernia. There is intestinal obstruction here, but the blood supply is preserved. That is obstructed hernia. Then we have the next type of hernia, which is called as strangulated hernia. So in strangulated hernia, if you see, in this the intestinal obstruction is present. There is intestinal obstruction with impaired blood supply. There is intestinal obstruction and the blood supply is impaired. Intestinal obstruction with impaired blood supply is strangulated hernia. Then we have enterocele. What is enterocele? In enterocele, the content of the hernia is the small intestine. And if you try to reduce, the first part is always difficult to reduce. The first part is always difficult to reduce. Then the last part is easier to reduce. This is enterocele. Then the next type we have is omentocele. What do you see in omentocele? Omentocele, the content is actually, as the name says, it is omentum. And in omentocele, if you see, the first part in omentocele is easy to reduce. Whereas if you see the second part in omentocele is difficult to reduce. Then we have the next type, which is called as Litter's hernia. What is Litter's hernia? In Litter's hernia, the content of Litter's hernia is Meckel's diverticulum. If Meckel's diverticulum is present in has the content, then it is Litter's hernia. Then we have Ammaillard's hernia. What is Ammaillard's hernia? Ammaillard's hernia is, if the content is appendix, then we call it as Ammaillard's hernia. So these are the different names of the hernia. Thank you.